Every one of us has clinical questions throughout our careers. I invite you to send your own personal questions to me. What is a small diameter implant? Look at this graphic with me for just a moment. A mini or a small diameter or an SDI or a narrow diameter, it has numerous names, is an implant that is root formed from about 1.8 millimeters up to 2.9 millimeters in diameter with an average length of about 13 millimeters. That's the most popular size that's sold. And it usually has screw-like characteristics. In other words, not a blunt end as a typical implant with which you're accustomed has, where you make a hole in the bone and you screw the thing in and it does not widen the bone. It just sits in the hole until the osteoblasts crawl into the titanium or titanium alloy and integrate. Now, a small diameter implant such as we just discussed can be placed in an extremely small amount of bone facial-lingual. About 3 to 4 millimeters from facial to lingual will allow a small diameter implant to be placed. However, most of you are very familiar with conventional diameter implants. Now we're talking about 3 millimeters and wider, clear on up to 6 and in some countries even 7 millimeters in diameter, with an average length of somewhere around 11 to 13 millimeters. These are usually tapered or parallel-sided. The one you're looking at is a tapered one, and it usually has a blunt end. That means I can't spread the bone with it very much. I have to make a hole almost the size of the implant and place the implant in and again wait for the osteoblast to integrate with that tapered or straight-sided implant. That kind of an implant of an average size of, let's say, 4 millimeters requires about 6 millimeters of bone facial lingual to be adequately placed. And what's a wide body implant? This has come later and it's basically a conventional diameter implant with just a wider body going clear on up to 6 or 7 millimeters, as I said. A conventional diameter and wide body are about the same. We could classify them as one, but the wide body has come later and therefore is highly useful in bones such as type 2 bone in the posterior part of the mandible, where it's hard on the outside and soft on the inside. And that wider body is allowed to go into the facial lingual bone with a terminology that you would recognize as bicortical, hard bone front, hard bone back, and pith in the middle, requiring a wide implant. That's certainly not an area into which you would place a small diameter implant because it would be hanging down into nothingness between the two hard pieces of bone. So I can divide it into 3 categories, but really it's only 2. The small diameter implant and the conventional diameter implant, some of which are wide body. For continuing information from us, please go to our website, pccdental.com. There are constantly changing informational and educational pieces there that we would love to have you see.